and also May of Slow Food Kitchen, and we have had the fantastic opportunity of meeting him today and trying food from his wonderful new book at the Google Canteen in London. So it's been quite an exciting morning. So Farron's translator Lucy is going to help us along with the interview. But I wonder if you could just tell us a little bit about the book, a little bit of background.
¿Le puedes decir algunas palabras sobre el libro y cómo se originó?
Bueno, es un libro, primero, es un libro normal para gente normal con cocina normal.
It's a, first of all, Farron wants to state that it's a normal book with normal food. For normal people.
Yes.
Esto una. Dos, que es el trabajo de tres años que hicimos en el Bulli para el equipo de la familia, ¿no? Para el equipo del Bulli que llamamos la familia.
Mm-hmm. So the origin of this book stems from the recipes they started creating for the family meals, the Bulli family meals. Yeah. The staff meals are called the family meal. That's what they call it, and they, after 3 years of compiling and working out the menus, they thought it was a good idea to turn it into a book for home chefs.
Y que me está sirviendo para reflexionar sobre el tema de la cocina en casa.
And at the same time, through the process of making this book, it's helping him to think and reflect upon what home cooking is really about or what it should be about.
Y que ojalá sirva para hacer reflexionar a todo el mundo de la gastronomía, de la cocina, y que ayude, ¿no?, en el futuro.
And hopefully this book will also help a lot of other professionals and people to think a little bit about what home cooking should be about.
Yes.
And people cooking at home.
Y que está claro que hay algo que hacemos mal.
And it's evident friends concluded that they've been doing something wrong.
Todo.
Everybody.
Que es que en un momento de locura alrededor de la cocina, blogs, televisión, media, todo, la gente no cocina en casa.
That in spite of all the press and TV covering food and food shows and also bloggers, it's obvious that something's gone wrong because there's a lot of talk about it, but people don't cook at home.
I completely agree, actually, and my theory is, and something that I'm very passionate about, is children aren't learning to cook. I think that is the problem.
Ella es la apasiona mucho este tema porque ella cree que, por ejemplo, que los niños no están aprendiendo a cocinar.
Yeah.
No, pero siempre porque si los padres no cocinan, es imposible que cocinen los hijos.
But obviously, if children don't have an example at home, you can't expect them to be cooking.
No, I completely understand, and I think for me, one of the reasons I am so passionate about it is I learned in school. For 3 years,
yes,
I had education and learning all of the basics, and my mother worked, so I couldn't learn at home either.
Yeah.
So I think we have a responsibility to make sure that children are taught. But I think this is fantastic, and I think it's a great start because you've got this campaign now with other chefs at the moment about getting people cooking.
Has empezado como una especie de campaña con otros cocineros sobre la cocina.
Bueno, sería bonito que otros chefs tuvieran este pragmatismo muy sencillo y que hicieran cada uno su visión, ¿no?
It would be a good thing for other well-known chefs or other chefs to have a similar pragmatic approach and give their vision of what home cooking should be about.
Lo único que les digo es que piensen que están para cocinando para gente, la mayoría que no gana más de 1.500 euros.
And to keep in mind that that it's about cooking for, you know, families and people that maybe are not making more than 1,000-1,500 euros a month.
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
Do you think it's easy for people to learn to cook from a book, or do they need to go and learn from somebody else?
¿Es fácil aprender a cocinar de este libro, o tendrían que ir primero a algún sitio?
Yo llevo 15 días en una escuela, muy sencilla, para coger el cuchillo, las cuatro cosas básicas, y después sí.
Farron normally recommends that if you have no experience cooking, then go to a cooking school and do a simple like crash course where you learn some of the basics like cutting and some of the elementary fundamentals of cooking, and then this is easy.
Okay, so the instructions in your book are quite simple that people can follow it from just straight from the book?
Las instrucciones son bastante sencillas en este libro.
Sí, lo que pasa es que la cocina es como todo, hay que hacer entrenamiento. Ella no, la primera vez que cogió esta cámara no salió bien.
It's like everything, everything requires a little bit of training. The first time you picked up and used this camera, I'm sure it didn't, you didn't get a great video. People think and expect that it has to come out right the first time.
Yeah, and that's correct. Yes. It doesn't. You need to be prepared to fail. Really.
I guess that experiment. Is para fallar.
Yeah. An experiment, play.
Lo bueno de estas recetas es que la mayoría, si no quedan tan tan bien, quedan bien.
The good thing about these recipes is that even if they don't work out exactly right, they won't be bad.
Yes. Yeah.
Un guacamole, si le pones un poquito más, un poquito menos, siempre queda bien.
Some things, you know, if you've overdone the avocado or the tomato in the guacamole, it's not going to ruin it.
No, exactly, exactly. It's just normal food for normal people. Yeah. Okay, great. So what's next for you, Fernando?
Yeah. No, tiene que, sobre todo, ahora que esto, hay un proyecto muy bonito que vamos a hacer con Telefónica en Barcelona, el 17 y 18 de octubre, que es una reunión por primera vez muy seria de blogs y gente de tecnología, lo que te cocina, gente de tecnología, para plantearnos cuál es el futuro del mundo de internet en la cocina.
A friend would like to announce to you that there's a project with Telefónica that they're having a meeting with bloggers and people involved in technology from around the world. It's on the 17th and 18th of October, and it's going to be open to people to reflect upon what the new technologies are bringing to society.
Porque es muy interesante saber el papel de internet, ¿no?
It's a really interesting and important thing to try and understand the role of internet in current society.
Falta ordenar todo esto.
Maybe we need to put some order into all of this.
Yes, because we're both bloggers.
El 17 es una reunión de bloggers.
Yeah. And the 17th is a meeting for bloggers.
Great.
And how does that involve food, or it's just technology?
¿Qué relación tiene con el tema de la cocina?
No, son bloggers de cocina.
They're cooking, cuisine.
Oh, food bloggers.
Food bloggers.
We should go.
Esto va a ser interesante, por ejemplo, el tema de cómo, para el tema de los idiomas, de cómo se hace para que puedan entrar con el tema de la traducción.
For example, it'll be interesting to see how they deal with the language barriers as well.
Porque pues, tú puedes traducir y todo esto, pero claro.
Of course, you can have an online translator.
Pero bueno, que esperamos.
Wonderful.
They'll be waiting for you there.
Fantastic. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.